paano ko magbabasa? Okay lang po, nakatayo lang, okay?
Gusto po, nakatayo.
Okay lang tayo.
Nag-sarapish na.
Lapit, lapit, lapit ang mic. Lapit.
Nag-song pakigal.
Lapit ang mic, actually. Lapit.
Good day to everyone. I'm Maria Contreras S. Robles, and you can call me Chris. Our story for today is a classic Disney poem that tells the most important attitude in our life. That is, perseverance. The main character for today is a hero, and his name is Perseus. Let's start. There was a king named Acrisius. He had a beautiful daughter named Danae. The oracle of Apollo told Acrisius that Danae's son would one day kill him. Acrisius could not let it happen, so he locked Danae in a bronze tower so that she would never marry or have a children. The tower had no doors, but it had one very small window. Danae was very sad. But one day, a bright shower of gold came through the small window. A man appeared. He had a thunderbolt in his hand. Danae knew he was a god, but she didn't know which. The man said, "Yes, I am a god, and I wish to make you my wife. I can make the stars a wonderful sunny land with many flowers." All happiness is sad. The horrible prison became feels almost as wonderful as the Elysian fields themselves. But one day, a creature saw light coming out of the small window. He told his man to tear down one of the walls. He walked into the tower and saw Danae, the baby on her lap. Smiling, she said, "And have you named him Perseus?" Acrisius was furious. Shot Danae and baby Perseus up in a large chest and cast them out to sea. Somehow, they went safely to the island of Seriphus, where Polydectes was king. King's brother, who was a fisherman, got them in his net and pulled them to shore. His name was Dictus. Perseus grew up to become a strong young man. Polydectes heard about Danae and wanted her to marry him, but she rejected him. Polydectes would have married Danae by force if Perseus wasn't there to protect her. Polydectes decided on a plan to get rid of Perseus. Polydectes pretended to be marrying a daughter of a friend of his. Everybody had to give a present, including Perseus. Polydectes pretended to be furious that Perseus had an empty-handed, but it was not only very strong and brave, yet very poor. "What? No wedding present?" yelled Polydectes. "I don't have any money," exclaimed Perseus. "Fine," said Perseus. rules of law. If you live in Oregon, if you're against something, turn, just don't. Then suddenly, a tall woman, long man, with big sandals appeared. The man said, "I am Hertz, and this is our sister Athena. Yes, you are a son of Zeus. We have some things that may help you in slaying Medusa. Here are my winged sandals. The magic wand, which will tell you how to get to the nymphs of the north. You must find the cry and get them to tell you how to get to the nymphs of the north. They will give you a cap of darkness, give you a magic wand, and tell you how to get to the nymphs of the north. And here is a gift from you," said Athena. "Use the shield to reflect the image of Medusa, so you won't return to stone."
Pwedeng i-hold na lang
So Perseus na lang para hindi siya nahihirapan. While he was way too women. There were three of them having only one
eye. Hirap tumalis pag lumapit.
All three of them.
Kasi nililipad yung papel.
All three of them, which they constantly fought over. Perseus hid behind some bushes and watched them. When one took out of the eye to give to another, Perseus ran from his eye and snatched the eye from them. Then he said, "I have your eye, and if you don't tell me how to get to the nymphs of the north, she'll never have it back." So they reluctantly told them how to get to the nymphs of the north. He gave them back their eye and flew off on his winged sandals. Then how the nymphs of the north gave him the cap of darkness, which has the power to make its wearer invisible. Magic wand. They told him how to reach the Gorgon's lair. Perseus went farther north until he found an island surrounded by rocks. Its statues used to command. Perseus raised his shield and saw Medusa and her sister asleep. He put the cap of darkness and flew down, swung the sickle, and felt it tearing through the skin of gold. Stealing, licking into the shield, he put Medusa's head into the magic wand. Medusa's sister woke up and attacked Perseus, who flew quickly away on his winged sandals and was not hurt. On his way back to the surface, he had many adventures. One was that when he saw Atlas holding up the sky, Perseus was sorry. For Atlas is turning to stone by showing him the head of Medusa, so he could no longer feel the weight of his burden.
Nahirapan siya talaga. Lumilipad si Kay po, yun na lang.
Later, saw what looked like a statue chained to a rock. Look down. Saw that it was not a statue, but a woman. He asked why she was chained to the rock. "My name is Andromeda, and I have been punished because of my vain mother. She boasted that I was more beautiful than the Nereids. Satan was angered and said that I must be sacrificed to a sea monster." She said, even as she spoke, a monster rose from the sea. Perseus pulled Medusa's head out of the mouth, out of the wand. The sea monster turned to stone and crumbled to pieces. Perseus cut Andromeda's chain and took her to the wand. King Cepheus of Phoenicia. When Perseus asked Andromeda's hand in marriage, Cepheus gladly agreed. So Perseus, with Andromeda in his arms, set off for a circus. On the way, they stopped at Larissa, so Perseus could complete some games. When he grew a discus, he took an old man. His chance was atrocious, so the prophecy came true. And after mourning for a while, Perseus and Andromeda left. When they arrived at Seraphis, the first Persian they met was Dictys, the fisherman who brought the name Perseus to shore after they sailed in the trunk.